Welcome back to Danny Robertson Music, where we're here to help you become the performer that you're meant to be. I'm Danny Robertson. Thanks for joining me this week. Today, you're catching me on the road. I'm headed to a gig that's a little drive away, and I'm excited about this gig because it's a place I've never played before, and it's a well-known college town that has a really cool football stadium, and I'm playing in one of the ballrooms that is at that stadium. So figured I'd show you a little bit about what an actual gig day looks like for me. So we're gonna have fun today. The group that I'm playing with today is it's actually a single band, but it's made up of about 30 some musicians that take turns filling different roles for every single gig, and so the gig doesn't always have the same players on it. And in fact, it's set up in a way that this single band can be in multiple places at once and provide the same level of show pretty much wherever we are and whatever concoction has been put together of people. The reason this group is set up the way that it is has a lot to do with the fact that the guy that started the band originally had it set up as about a six-piece band that would cover all of the gigs. And then he started getting requests to play multiple gigs on the same day, and he really hated the fact that he couldn't say yes to all of them. He would have to say, no, we're already booked for another gig, so we can't play that one for you today. And so that started him putting together multiple versions of the same band. And originally it was designed as two separate bands, but it made more sense to make all of the performers interchangeable so that we could all cover different gigs when they were necessary. So the band can be put together as anything as little as a three-piece jazz unit, but as big as, I think the biggest one we have this summer is a 14-piece or a 12-piece where there's four different singers, there's a full horn line, there's a full band, and it's a lot of fun when those kinds of gigs happen. But basically, we're now at the point where the band gets requested to play multiple gigs on the same dates, and that gives everybody an opportunity to play a little bit more and make a little bit of more money. So it's a lot of fun. Today will be one of those days. We have another one coming up next week where we have, again, three different versions of the band playing in three different places all at the same time. So it's a neat way to be a performer because the gigs never feel stale. You're always playing with a slightly different group of people, and it makes it a lot of fun because it's ever-changing. It always makes every gig feel exciting. So stay tuned. We're going to show you the venue in a little bit here when I get there, and we'll walk you through a few more things at the gig today. Should be a lot of fun. So we had a little bit of construction, but I believe we have arrived to the location where we're supposed to be playing. And I'm excited about this one because I'm going to pull this up. And we are right in that building right there. For those who don't recognize it, that is Notre Dame Stadium where they do Notre Dame football. And I'll be playing in that building right there. So should be a lot of fun. So here's tonight's venue location. And let me show you where we're playing at. A neat little spot right here. This is a first. We're going to have fun tonight. Awesome. That's the way we like it. That's perfect. All right. Cool.
So is that why girls like...
Thank you.
out with me?
Sure.
Hop on in. From the gig right now, and it was a pretty good gig. It was really fun to play Notre Dame Stadium for the first time. We talked with the staff quite a bit tonight. They were very friendly people, and from what we understand, the stadium has the ability to have three separate receptions in three different ballrooms that are on three different sides of the stadium all at the same time, and that's kind of what was happening tonight. There were two happening at the same time, and it was a lot of fun. The ballroom was beautiful, and at the same time, it also had a great view of the field. The crowd loved the event. It was a very high-class event. I believe there was a lot of money spent to have this event at this location. And, you know, we had a good show. It was a little rough around the edges. We had a few mistakes that happened here and there, and there were some misses on, you know, ending a song all at the same time, but we were able to come through with it clean. And it got me thinking, like, these kinds of shows, it's really weird to say this, but I find that some shows, it tends to be that if there's a little bit of chaos, there's a little bit of, like, the feeling of being a little out of control, it almost helps the audience have a little bit more fun. The band is not super tight, but it's very solid, and it's a little bit rough around the edges. And that seems to be this great recipe for making it loose and fun and exciting and loud and good for the audience. It really makes the audience jump in and join the party with both hands. And so we had a great show. The bride and groom loved it. The entire wedding party loved it. The parents of the families loved it. And we got some extra tip money because of it. I really enjoyed the show. So overall, the first experience at Notre Dame Stadium was great. And I have another one coming up next month, and it should be a lot of fun. I can't say anything more than that. I will say this. If you feel like you want to learn more about how to create these high-end performances, I can teach you a lot about that. So do me a favor. Check out DannyRobertsonMusic.com and download a freebie if you feel like trying them out, and check out our courses. There's a lot of things to see out there. And we teach a lot of different things about how to engage your audience, create a show that is not just playing music. It's more about creating a performance that builds an experience with your audience. It really grabs your audience and makes them feel like they are part of this event that you guys have created together. And we teach a lot about that. I've even, the singer that sang tonight, I've taught her. And we've done a lot of coaching on that kind of stuff. So anyway, I think that's it for this week. Hope you enjoyed this video, and we will talk to you soon. Take care.